Our today's topic will going to be very interesting because one country do have stealth technology and the other do not have. But the one bizarre part between these two countries are they are not defending against each other. These two countries are always in belligerent mood. The countries I am talking about are Russia and USA. Maybe Russia do not have stealth fighter technology or the stealth jets, but the Russia have came up with something which is very interesting, which is a very high frequency radar, which could be able to detect American F-35 and F-22 stealth fighter jet. The use of could be very cynical in the Russian case. I would like to use will be, which will be the perfect for our today's discussion. The very high frequency radar Russia will be using in the hilltop of Karzunova Air Base is Rezonans-NE. By using this radar, Russia will be able to look deep into the NATO territory, including Norway and Finland. By the way, Finland still not the part of NATO, they applied for the NATO membership. So, today we will going to discuss this topic with minute detail, because if it is true, then the USA will have to face serious threat in Europe. Now let's talk about the Russia's Rezonans-NE. What are the places Russia choose to install these radars? You know, Russia is a massive country. It is basically a transcontinental country spanning Eastern Europe and the Northern Asia. Russia is the world's largest country by area with at least 12 crore population. So to protect this big country, Russia needs bigger radars, and the Rezonans-NE is one of them. Rezonans-NE is capable of spotting hypersonic missiles too, along with stealth fighter jet. Russia's third Rezonans-NE has been operational around June 2021 in the Arctic region. It is in the Arctic Novaya Zemlya Archipelago. The first two were deployed near the towns of Shiona, located in Kola Peninsula in the northern Nenets Autonomous Okrug, and Indiga in the northern Nenets Autonomous District in the northern European part of Russia. Two more radars are coming live in Gremikha and Zaporlenie, about 30 km away from the Russian-Norwegian border. These units will conduct round-the-clock surveillance of the airspace above the northern regions of Norway and Finland. We are particularly interested about Russia's Karzunova Air Base installation, because this installation particularly for the NATO's F-35 counter. The location for installation was first announced in 2020. According to the experts, the construction has been going on since July 2021, as seen in the latest satellite image. The facility located near Zaporlenie, a mining town about 10 km from Russia's border with Norway. The facility comprises 4 radar modules covering 90 degrees and can see an entire circular area. The Rezonans-NE radar operate in a meter band and they employ the principles of wave resonance, allowing it to detect the stealth aircraft and the hypersonic targets flying at a speed of up to Mach 20. The radar is capable of detecting targets at a distance of 600 km and at a targets of 1200 km on the ballistic targets at an altitude of up to 100 km. And according to reports, the complex is without rotating antennas and has a transmitter antenna feeder and the elevation antenna feeder devices, as well as the radar data receiving and the processing system. Once the installation will be finished, the Russia will have a sufficient field of operation to keep an eye on the skies of above Rovaniemi in Finland and the Evenes Airport in Norway. These two places are current and the future bases of F-35. The NATO already has a pair of F-35 jets in Evenes in Norway. Now the question is, why NATO have F-35 in Evenes, far north in Norway? The first reason is Russia, and the last reason is also Russia. Basically, NATO designated Russia as the biggest threat to the European so-called unity. The European friendship is kind of an hypocritical oath. In the 19th century, the war was fought in the name of colonial domination. In the 20th century, the world again fought in the name of democracy against Nazism and Fascism. But 21st century war will be on Arctic. So these war games are just the trial versions of the Arctic war in the name of natural resources. NATO put those pair of F-35 jets in Evenes to assign for the quick response alert missions. The missions to intercept Russian aircraft flying out of the Kola Peninsula. The first of the Finland's F-35 scheduled to enter services in 2025 will be based in Rovaniemi. The Russia is not only the sole user of this antenna, they have also sold it to Iran. According to the news agency, the Russian state-affiliated news agency TASS, the Iran is also using them against any F-35 invasion from the Israeli or the American side. The Russia is planning to install more radars along the Russia's Arctic coastline from Kola Peninsula in the west to the Bering Strait in the east. I was wondering for the one more questions, and the question is, The question actually arises from our previous discussion, which is why Kola Peninsula is so important to Russia. I would like to give you an answer, but very briefly. The Kola Peninsula actually the part of the Russian Murmansk Oblast. It is the part of the Russia's northwest Arctic Russia. The peninsula is the crux of the Russia's military establishments in the western Arctic. Its air and the maritime capabilities are essential to the Russia's homeland defense, Arctic dominance and the global power projections. In the Kola Peninsula, Russia have modernized Shevremov 1 air base, the Gadzhievo submarine base and the Okhotnaya submarine support base. These bases have significantly improved the Russia's operational readiness and ability to control the surrounding maritime space in the Arctic. The Kola Peninsula also home to the system, a system called the RS-24YARS, which is a thermonuclear intercontinental ballistic missile. So this poses the great threat to US and its other NATO allies, other NATO European allies. But beating Russia in the Arctic region will be a great challenger for the United States and its NATO allies. Now let's talk about the technicality of the resonance radar, which might help you in preparing different kinds of exams, the exam like PSC exams and the UPSC exam. So let's start. The radar system can identify and follow even the most complicated air targets. The Rezonans-NE is a high-frequency early warning phased array radar. It is intended to detect various present and the potential air targets, including low observable cruise and the ballistic missiles, hypersonic missiles and aircrafts. It can even detect all these targets in an environment with the strong electronic countermeasures and clutter. The radar system has the following modes of operation. The first mode is designed to detect and track mainly aerodynamic targets. The second mode is designed to detect and track high altitude, mainly ballistic targets. The radar can run in a predetermined sector or a circular scan mode. It can provide the information support for the air and the air defense warfare operation as well as the early warning of an air attack. The Rezonans-NE has the four modules. The four module consists of a transit antenna feeder device and the received azimuth and the elevation antenna feeder device and a power amplifier. The radar's data receptions and the processing system collects and processes the data in the four modules. The radar data receiving and the processing apparatus as well as the probe signal generator are the digital devices controlled by the specialized processor. The four module radar, which covers a 100 cross 100 meter area, scans a 360 degree sector. According to the Russia's military expert, Yuri Nutov stated that the Rezonans-NE is a highly effective radar system that incorporates artificial intelligence components. This technology enables the stations to simulate an electronic image of a target and precisely identify its type with flight parameters. The resonance radar capable of identifying and designate targets at a distance of up to 600 km for aerodynamic air targets and up to 1200 km for ballistic targets, that I have already told you. The system finds targets at up to 100 km in altitude simultaneously. The resonance intelligence is also excellent. The radar station has a framed and the four recognition system, and it can function reliably in the winds up to 50 meters per second at the lowest and the highest air temperatures. During combat operation, the radar is said to be able to track more than 500 targets simultaneously, giving early warning at an air attack, informing aviations and the anti-aircraft defense systems about the air situation. The Rezonans-NE is typically set up on the ground as a square of four modules. However, the radar can be built in one module, two module or the three variant segments of 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degree respectively. Russia can design in this way according to the customer need. So it is an excellent radar that can prove to be an American stealth killer. Obviously, this radar will work in the conjugance with either S-400 or S-500 missile defense system. And the S-500 missile defense system is already proven to be a killer according to the Russian Defense Ministry. That's why they have increased the productions of S-500 amid Ukrainian war. We human beings are in self-destructive mode. Our survival is on timer. When the timer will stop, then ultimate peace will prevail in this world. Now the question, the first question is, what is Hermit, which has been seen in the news? The first option is satellite, second is vaccine, third is spyware, fourth is missile. The second question is, in May 2022, the INS Gomti has decommissioned at which of the dockyard, which of the naval dockyard? The first option is naval dockyard Chennai, second is Kochi, third is Kolkata, fourth is Mumbai. So this is the end of the topic. If you have any inquiry about this topic or any other kinds of inquiry, then you can mail me to my email address, which is twin.power.academy@gmail.com. So thank you very much. Thank you for your attention. I hope you will find this topic informative.